A woman draws strength from troubles, smiles during distress, and grows stronger with prayers and hope. So wishing you all once again a happy Women's Day. Thank you.
Mr. Vinny Sharma, the principal of the Government College for Women. Nisha Bhagat, the assistant professor here and the convener of the program. And I would also like to inform all of you that she has been my student. And she has done her MA in sociology and she has done her MPhil under me. In a way, I can say she is my research scholar. And I am really proud of that. All the faculty members, colleagues, students and friends. First of all, a happy International Women's Day to all of you. 8th March, as it has been already said, is celebrated the worldwide. It is not in a particular village, town, city or any country, but throughout the world it is celebrated. You know, in adverse condition, in extreme form of poverty, you know, and inequality. Think of all those people, think of your own self. And I think that, you know, as I said, that it has to begin from within the family. You know, I will just say that, you know, one of my students who's doing MPhil right now under me, she's working on COVID-19, and you know that UN theme this year has been on fighting and challenging COVID-19 situations where women have played a very, very important role. She's about to submit her MPhil, you know, which is a degree, which will lead for her further higher education. And as she's about to submit, she's completed her fieldwork and everything, and she tells me that, ma'am, I will not be able to complete my MPhil because my parents have arranged my marriage, which is just in 2 months' time. In fact, they are saying that 2 months are very less to make preparation of marriage. I said, you have been working for 1.5 years now and you are about to submit. It's your degree. It's so, I was like very disturbed and also angry with her, though I didn't show. I said, you follow your parents, but at least go and tell them that how important it is for you to be educated. You are the privileged one to be there. And I would say that I have been to several villages all over the country, and maybe more villages than you people would have done. I have covered at least 20 to 25 villages in the Jammu district itself, you know, the border villages. And I have seen that the mothers of the young girls, they are so keen. They said ki humne padhai nahi ki hai, lekin hum chahte hai ki hamari bachiyan aage padhai kare. Aur unke jo majbooriyan hain, unki jo pareshaniyan hain, wo bahut zyada hain. Aur wo kis tarah se un ladkiyon ko aage karna chahti hai. They even have to fight their own husbands and elders in the family. So I told her, she is from a business family, businessman, and she is marrying a person who is also a businessman, and they are very rich. I said, you are not realizing the value of education because you have money with you, you know. And okay, I said, you can think about it. Though you don't have to fight, but you have to, you know, that everyday resistance is something which all girls and women have to undertake. So after about 10 to 15 days, she came and she said that, ma'am, my parents, I just talked to them in a very polite manner, and they said that, okay, your marriage will be next year. So then I was glad that at least she could complete her MPhil. But the only thing is, the reason which she gave me was very different.
Kabhi bed sone ke alawa khel ka maidan hota hai. खाने की मेज पर खाने के अलावा अपनों का साथ होता है, इसीलिए तो हम कहते हैं कि एक मकान घर तब बनता है जब वो KS फर्नीचर से सजता है। रिश्तों की मिठास का एहसास KS फर्नीचर के साथ।